Hello guys, welcome back to a brand new video today. Now today, as you might realise, my channel might have changed. It is starting to get ready for the World Cup. Now I've got my 23 who I selected before the World Cup team was announced. So what I want you to do, I'm gonna name Gareth Southgate 23 plus to stand by this as well, just in case for any injuries. I want you to vote who's got the better team, either me or Southgate. There might be a few I want in my team, but whether we've got the more threat back, that's why there is a few left. Few left in the back row. And before I get down to that, I just want to say, our last tournament, which was Euro 2016, they got knocked out 2-1 against Iceland. And there used to be a stand down on the football app when if you're only as good as your last competition, well, you got knocked out against Iceland, so you can't do any worse. There was a few things that did disappoint me during the qualifiers. We only beat Malta 1-0 over there. And I just expect Malta to be 10. We should be rushing inside 6-7-0. I think it was roughly the same result for San Marino, if I remember. But I'm very disappointed with the actual national team. As you can tell, I wear the England shirt. Obviously I'll support the boys anyway throughout this World Cup. But I'm a bit disappointed with the 23 I've been named as well. I'll give you a few of my pointers on the team, and then I'll run you through my team as well. So, without any further ado, guys, subscribe for more, thanks for watching, and let's go. So, in goal, it was Jordan Pickford, Jack Butlin, and Nick Pope. Three goalkeepers I completely agree with. Now, Nick Pope done an excellent job coming from Tom Hilton, and obviously picked up the injury. Jack Butlin was very unlucky to get relegated with Stoke. I think he'd be on a possible move. And Jordan Pickford, I think he's one of the future up and coming keepers in goal for Everton as well as for England. So I'm quite happy with that, and only three as our keepers. Alex, now this is the defence. Alexander Arnold, Gary Cahill, Phil Jones, Harry Maguire, Danny Rose, John Stones, Kieran Trippier, Kyle Walcott and Ashley Young. Now, one thing I do want to question about that, Chris was supposed to play 3 at the back, and I think what about 9 or 12 defenders? Surely that guy used that much over there. But Alexander Arnold, now if I was him, I don't want to question it. He's never actually played for the England senior squad. But if Joe Gomez was fit, would that Alexander Arnold be going over? So that's one thing I'm questioning about Gareth Southgate's selection for the World Cup. Is in his shadow because he's injured, he took Alexander Arnold. This is my argument of friendlies. When we play the friendlies, I don't think it's our first team. I think we should play the young boys, give them a senior cap, and take it from there. So that's just my opinion. Then in midfield, we've got Dele Alli, Tooth, Eric Dyer, Jordan Henderson, Lingard, Rubus off the cheek, and Raheem Sterling. Rubus off the cheek, I completely agree. Perfect centre midfield for Palace this season. That does rub it in a bit, especially being a Barton there, but no, I think he's got great talent, and I think he's going to be a good leading the squad in the future. Dele Alli and Willison doing much this season. You'll see my squad in a minute, and you'll see what changes I will make. Ain't really seen him play. I don't know why he's managed to creep in. Eric Dyer, I think he just about made it. Jordan Henderson, see which I've all gone one or two midfield in the centre of defence as well. Jordan Henderson, I think he just managed to creep in from all of this. Jesse Lingard, right wing off. Now, as I said, Rubens off the cheek. Deserves it. Raheem Sterling. You know, this 23 just does make me question, you know, how far we want to get in these competitions. I mean, for me, I've bet most of us have never seen England win the World Cup, but we like to. But you see, as I said, stream on the field in a minute, and plus what defense to my attack. This is the Gareth Southgate's attack. Harry Kane, Marcus Rashford, Jamie Vardy, Danny Welbeck. Now, how has Danny Welbeck got into the England squad? No disrespect to Danny Welbeck, you've hardly played. If you have played, you came and got injured. I'd like to know how he's managed to creep in there. Yet again, throw names out the hat. Charlie Austin comes off the bench for Southampton. Fair enough, he ain't played that badly. He's got a few goals, but I've got a funny feeling as soon as Danny Welbeck touches the pitch, he's going to pick up an injury. As I said, no disrespect. You know, you could have got Peter Crouch out of retirement. This is what makes me question the team a lot. And this is Gareth Southgate's standby list, which is Tom Hilton, James Tomkinson, sorry for mispronouncing your name, Lewis Kirk, Jake Livermore, and Adam Lallana. Now, I can see Gareth Southgate's put Lallana on his standby list, but another way I can't. If it was me, this World Cup, I'll go young. Adam Lallana is actually 30. Time the next competition comes around, it's going to be about 32, 34, somewhere around there. So, I don't get the idea of that. Jake Livermore, he's done alright for West Brom, but don't deserve a spot. As far as I'm thinking, you might disagree. If you do, just put it in the comments below. Lewis Kirk, yeah, I'll put him in. James Tomkinson, yeah, again. If I was the England manager, I would want my defenders to put own body on the line. Which I'll get more to that once I tell you my list. And Tom Hilton, fair enough. Obviously just missed out on that top three. Now, going on to my 23, this is my own personal perspective. Put your 23 down below. I'm interested to know who you would have took. I'm sure there's some down here that you wouldn't agree with. But anyway, put your three down below. It'd be pretty interesting to see what team you would have took to the World Cup. My top three was Jordan Pickford, Nick Pope, Jack Butlin. Perfect. Got him three dead on. Now my defence, now it is true, I've only got 5 defenders. But if I remember right, if we get pick up a serious injury over there, because they're ruled out, we can pick up another one. But this is right back 5, because I thought we'd go with back 3 anyway. Lewis Dunk, who obviously puts his body on the line for Brighton. That's obviously just not because he's Brighton based, but he does do a good defender's job. Leighton Baines. Now I'll put Leighton down there purely because, yeah, again he's experienced, but yet he can play wing back as he's done a few times for Everton. Phil Jagielka, yeah, experienced, bit old, but I think we have been good if we need like last 10 minutes of good defender to bring on. Carl Walker. Now yet again, he's been selected to go to that coach squad, so I ain't saying nothing there. Michael King is young. I think he is good and up and coming defender. I think we've been interested to see him in there. Yeah again, instead of Alexander Arnold, where Alexander Arnold is concerned. I think he's going to feel a bit lost out there. Never actually played for other senior cap, but then put straight into a World Cup squad. I'm interested to see how he's going to settle over there, especially in a strange country and all that, but it's going to be interesting. And then I'll put Pierre in Trippier. So I think I've got 2 out of the 12. But yeah, again, I piled in midfield, and I'll tell you that in a minute. Oh, sorry, one more defender, James Milner. Yet again, young, brilliant season at Liverpool, and yet again, to play on the wing back. But anyway, that's my defence. In my midfield, Sonny March, yet again, England international under 21, comes off the bench a few times for Brighton, and you'll be able to tell in a minute that it's not just because they're Brighton based. I've got a couple of past players down here as well, but it gets around in a minute. Aaron Lennon, yeah again, great winger. I'm not sure whether he's injured or not, but if he's not, it would have been great to see him out there. Yeah again, getting on a bit, but great experience for the youth, which is what you're going to need for the players. We're going to need to pass that experience on to the younger ones to try to get the best out of them. I went Jack Wiltshire. I thought he was very unfortunate not to make the World Cup squad. Yeah, he's picked up the injuries, but yeah, again, same as Danny Welbeck. So, you know, it's a bit of a shame. Nathan Redman, Southampton, yeah, again, can play wing back. I would have put him in there all day long, if I'm all honest. I don't think he's that old if I remember, but yet again, he's got Premier League experience. Southampton managed to keep him up, so he's got to be used to defending. No disrespect to Southampton. Andros Townsend, yet again, Palace player, yet again. I think he's getting on a bit, but yet again, his experience can come to hand with the youth. Rebus Office Cheeker we've got. Now this way I've gone a bit different. I've gone Damari Gray and Joker Shelby. Now that's my midfield. Joker Shelby I think deserves a spot in there, same as Damari Gray. Premier League title with Leicester, why not stick him in there? Or why not take him at least? And then at front I've gone with Jamie Vardy, Charlie Austin, Harry Kane and Reece Nelson. Now Reece Nelson, yet again, this is where my argument comes in with Damari, Gareth and Alex Arnold. Reece Nelson, only 18 years old. He ain't played that much for Arsenal, but what I've seen and heard, he's got the game. So yet again, why don't you take one of Welbeck out and then take Reece Nelson out there for the experience? And, you know, try and get him on 10 minutes before the end against, like, Tunisia or I think it's Nigeria we've got to play, and I know it's Belgium. So, you know, that's why my squad is like that. So we can bring players on, get the experience in the first team, and then develop their game. But anyway, that's just my matters of opinion. Guys, you know what to do. Comment below what your team is. Subscribe for more. Thanks for watching, and ciao for now.